My STEM project this year was testing the effectiveness of mycorrhizal remediation of phosphorus from stormwater. And so stormwater pollution, like when it rains, stormwater travels over pervious surfaces and it collects fertilizers and other pollutants into the bodies of water untreated. And so in a lot of fertilizers, there's phosphorus, and phosphorus is the number one cause of eutrophication. And so this is bad because eutrophication is when eventually all the oxygen is depleted from the water system and the organisms in there die, and it produces harmful algal blooms or that sort of thing. So in my experiment, I tested a stormwater mycorrhizal filter. And so mycorrhizae are fungi that form a symbiotic relationship with its host plant, where the mycorrhizae help to increase their pH of nutrients and of phosphorus and the water for the plant, while the plant provides the mycorrhizae with source of carbon. So knowing this, I hypothesized that mycorrhizae would be able to effectively increase the uptake of phosphorus in the stormwater. So to test this, I came up with a very simple filter design. I just used a Tupperware container and I drilled four holes at the bottom. And so half of the samples that I used had mycorrhizae in it and half of them didn't. And so what I did is I would pour nutrient solutions down the filter, and then I would test the solution that was filtered out of it for the total phosphorus concentration. So the very first thing that I had to do was to make sure that there was mycorrhizal infection. It's slightly hard to see in this picture, but these darker spots here are mycorrhizal vesicles, so they show that there was a presence of mycorrhizae that I had at two different treatments. And so in this graph, you can see this line represents the non-mycorrhizal filters, and this line represents the mycorrhizal filters. So you can see that it looks like there's definitely a treatment effect wherein the non-mycorrhizal samples in the filter seem to be better than phosphorus for the non-mycorrhizal samples. I did test the significance of this using a character test. This one was not quite statistically significant with a p-value of 0.08, but it was still very promising. So the next thing that I did was I checked for the plant tissue concentration of phosphorus. And so this was very exciting because it found that all the mycorrhizal samples had greater concentrations of phosphorus than the non-mycorrhizal samples, showing that they were able to obtain more phosphorus. And this was statistically significant. And then the most exciting thing, though, that I think I found, and I wasn't even looking for this in the first place, was that the percent of magnesium and the mycorrhizal tissues was also significantly greater, as you can see in this graph. And so you might be wondering why this is significant from studying phosphorus. And that's because a chlorophyll molecule is responsible for photosynthesis in the plant, and at the center of a chlorophyll molecule is a magnesium atom. And so this greater presence of magnesium is suggested greater photosynthetability for the mycorrhizal plants. And so basically in the future, the hope is to be able to implement these sort of mycorrhizal filters around retention ponds and rivers to help to mitigate the effects of stormwater pollution worldwide.
Yes.